fault entirely. For the white kitten had been having its face washed by the old cat for the last quarter of an hour, and bearing it pretty well, considering. So you see that it couldn't have had any hand in the mischief. The way Dinah washed her children's faces was this. First, she held the poor thing down by its ear with one paw, and then with the other paw, she rubbed its face all over the wrong way, beginning at the nose. And just now, as I said, she was hard at work on the white kitten, which was lying quite still and trying to purr, no doubt feeling that it was all meant for its own good. But the black kitten had been finished with earlier in the afternoon, and so while Alice was sitting curled up in a corner of the great armchair, half talking to herself and half asleep, the kitten had been having a grand game of romps with the ball of worsted Alice had been trying to wind up, and had been rolling it up and down till it had all come undone again. And there it was, spread over the hearth rug, all knots and tangles, with the kitten running after its own tail in the middle. She held it up to the looking glass that it might see how sulky it was. And if you're not good directly, she added, I'll put you through into the looking glass house. How would you like that? I'll tell you all my ideas about the looking glass house. First, there's the room you can see through the glass. That's just the same as our drawing room, only the things go the other way. Gyre and gimble in the wave, all mimsy were the burrow groves, and the mome rafts outgrave. Beware the jabberwock, my son, the jaws that bite, the claws that catch. Beware the jubjub bird, and shun the frumious bandersnatch. (Laughs) took his vorpal sword in hand. Long time the maxim foe he sought. He rested by the tum-tum tree and stood a while in thought. And as in uppish thought he stood, the Jabberwock with eyes aflame came whiffing through the tulgey wood and burbled as it came. Went snicker-snack. He left it dead, and with its head he went galumphing back. And hast thou slain the Jabberwock? Come to my arms, my beamish boy. O frabjous day, Callooh Callay, he chortled in his joy. 'Twas brillig, and the slithy toves did gyre and gimble in the wave. All mimsy were the burrow groves, and the moan rats outgrave. She had finished it, but it's rather hard to understand. You see, she didn't like to confess, even to herself, that she couldn't make it out at all. Somehow it seems to fill my head with ideas, only I don't know exactly what they are. However, somebody killed something. That's clear at any rate. But oh, thought Alice, suddenly jumping up, if I don't make haste, I shall have to go back through the looking glass before I've seen what the rest of the house is like. Let's have a look at the garden first. I should see the garden far better, said Alice to herself, if I could get to the top of that hill. And so she did, wandering up and down and trying turn after turn, but always coming back to the house, do what she would. Indeed, once when she turned a corner rather more quickly than usual, she ran up against it before she could stop herself. Thank you. ought I to follow, I wondered? It was not a difficult question to answer, as there was only one road, and the finger posts both pointed along it. I'll settle it, Alice said to herself, when the road divides and they point different ways. But this did not seem likely to happen. She went on, and a long way, but wherever the road divided, there were sure to be two finger posts pointing the same way. One marked to Tweedledum's house, and the other to the house of Tweedledee. They were standing under a tree, each with an arm round the other's neck, and Alice knew which was which in a moment, because one of them had dumb embroidered on his collar, and the other, D. I suppose they've each got Tweedle round at the back of the collar, she said to herself.